Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. My name is Asnah Binti Ismail, and I am the Vice President 2 for EMSS 1920. Alright, so I'm going to share about leadership today. But before that, one thing for sure is we are only a few days away from Shawwal. So I really hope that everyone in a pink of health, together with the beloved one wherever you are, make lots of dua and prayers, especially towards the end of Ramadan. And inshallah, may Allah grant all the wishes that we are wishing for. Alright, so today I want to share a vision of leadership with you, so that actually we all can begin to embrace the concept of leadership, which is actually around us, and that everybody can be a leader. You know, we all have our own perception of what leadership is and what leader is. And those perceptions are predominantly based on our own experience. I'm talking about it because it was from my own experience too. Perception can change, and I'm hoping to do a little bit of that today. Right? So if we look in the standard dictionary, the definition of leader will be given as something along the line, someone who's in charge, you know, someone who in control, someone who in command. And actually that's quite true lah, in many cases. But let me tell you something, what if there's a lot more to it than that? What if the scope of leadership reach far more wider than just, you know, a workplace or a society that you're involved in, or even the small group of friends that you do your assignment together with, right? But because that's how we used to see what leaders and leadership is, and I do really truly understand that, why people give that perception. But honestly, I don't believe it, you know? I believe that it can be reached even more wider, like better than this. Here is something that I want to clear up. Leadership isn't about your title or how high you are in your hierarchy. It also isn't about how many qualifications that you have. You know, it's also not about whether you are wealthy or not. And lastly, I think everyone will agree about this, that both males and females can be a good and fantastic leader. So none of these factors determine anyone's ability to lead. But it is also important that we realize it's not about having power or control over people, you know, for us to be a leader. And in my few years of working with leaders across various settings, I've learned numbers of styles of leadership that they portray. But what repeatedly and continually comes through in terms of what's important in leadership is trust. You know, true trust, an ordinary person that you think you are can change you into an amazing leader. Having that someone who has that strong positive impact and effect in our life, you know, mentally, emotionally and spiritually, in some ways usually make us feel comfortable with them. And when these people are genuine in what they do, this will help to establish the trust. And which I think it's often a rare commodity for us to, you know, use. But it's like gold dust, because we all need trust. So what I want to say here, for you to practice leadership, is actually you don't need any, you know, fancy verification from anyone or anywhere. By only practicing this one important value that I shared just now, which is trust, you can help so many people to get out of their tragic battle and be their source of light. And this will speak volume better when people start to trusting their secret to you, when people ask you for any recommendation. And the most significant example that I can give you is when they trust you to show how vulnerable they are in front of you, you know, because no one likes it when, you know, other people saw us being weak, right? So I hope this can be helpful in some ways, and you can find your own way to practice what everyday leadership is. So thank you so much for tuning in, and Selamat Hari Raya.